I leave behind me. She's a colleen I adore, and I wonder will she think of me when she hears the rifles roar. And when the war is over,
the sun was setting o'er the bright May meadows of Shelmaleer. A rebel hand set the heather blazing and brought the neighbors from far and near. Then Father Murphy from old Kilcommock spurred up the rocks with a warning cry. Ah, Mom, he cried, for I've come to lead you, for Ireland's freedom we fight or die. He led us on against the coming soldiers, and the cowardly yeomen we put to flight. Was at the Harrow the boys of Wexford showed Bookie's regiment how men could fight. Look out for hirelings, King George of England, search every kingdom where breeds a slave. For Father Murphy from County Wexford sweeps all the land like a mighty wave. We took him all in and Enniscorthy, and Wexford storming drove out our foes. 'Twas at Schlieffquil there our pikes were reeking with the crimson stream of the beaten eels. At Tobernearing and Bally Ellis full many a Hessian lay in his gore. Our Father Murphy had aid come over, the green flag floated from shore to shore. At Vinegar Hill or the pleasant Slaney, our heroes vainly stood back to back, and the yeos at Tullow took Father Murphy and burned his body upon the rack. God grant you glory, brave Father Murphy, and open heaven to all your men. For the cause that called you may call tomorrow in another fight for the green again.
And I quickly tell to you all the pretty girl I admire, name of Katie Donahue. She's fair and fat and 40, and believe me when I say, every time I went to courting her, I could hear her mother say, Johnny! to get up and the partner up and give a man a seat. Can't you see it's Mr. Maguire and he's courting your sister Kate? Oh, you know very well he owns a farm a wee bit out of town. Will you get up and that you important brat, let Mr. Maguire sit down. Oh, the first place that I met her was a dancer, Chandra Gee, and I asked her very politely if she'd dance a step with me. She wanted to know if I'd see her home if I was going her way, but I no sooner got inside the door than I heard her mother say, Johnny, get up in the bar, get up and give a man a seat. Can't you see it's Mr. Maguire and he's courting your sister Kate? Oh, you know very well he owns a farm a wee bit out of town. When you get up in the bar, she impert and rattle, let Mr. Maguire sit down. Oh, but now that we are married, sure the mother changed her mind. Just because I drank the legacy me father left behind. She hasn't got the decency to bid me time of day, and whenever I go near the door, I can hear her mother say, Johnny, come up to the bar, come up, you're sitting in a draft. Sure, it's only old Maguire, and he nearly drives me daft. I don't know what cage he took him for, he's always on the tear. Still, you sit where you are, and never you dare to give old Maguire the chair.
On the first day of spring in the year of 93, there was great recreation in this country. There were gentlemen and farmers over hills and dales and rocks. They all set out so joyfully in search of the fox.
Tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, me boys away, hark away.
When Reynard was started, he was facing to the moor, with Arklow and Wicklow along the seashore. He kept his brush in view every yard of the way, and straight he took his course right through the main street of Rosbray.
Tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, me boys away, hark away.
Now Reynard, sly Reynard, he hid in a tree that night, but they swore they would watch him until daylight. And early next morning the woods they did resound with the echo of horns and the sweet cry of hounds.
Tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, me boys away, hark away.
When Reynard left the tree, boys, he took to the hollow, where none but the hounds and the footmen could follow. The gentlemen cried, watch him, watch him, what shall we do? For if the rocks don't stop him, he'll go on to kill the loo.
Tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, me boys away, hark away.
When Reynard was taken, his wishes to fulfill, they called for ink and paper and a pen to write his will. And now you've come to mention it, they found it wasn't a prank, for he left them all a check on the National Bank.
Tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, me boys away, hark away.
To you, Mr. Casey, I leave me whole estate, and to you, Pat O'Brien, me money and me plate, and I leave to you, your ladyship, me brush, me mask and cap, for you took the walls and ditches and you never looked for a gap.
Tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, tally-ho, hark away, me boys away, hark away.
Men from Dublin town riding on the mountainside, fearless of the Saxon crown, 20 brothers true and tried. Blood flows in the city streets, there the green is lying low. Here the emerald standard greets
eyes alike of friend and foe. Fly the city, brothers, try, join us on the mountainside, where we've England's power defied, 20 men from Dublin town, 20 men from Dublin town, full of love and full of hate. Our chief, our tone is down, hand of God avenges fate. Joy it is whene'er we meet, red coats on the mountain track. Oh, as dear they must be fleet, if to Dublin they get back. Fly the city, brothers, try, join us on the mountainside, where we've England's power defied, 20 men from Dublin town, 20 men from Dublin town, every night around the fire, brimming measures toss we down, to our Captain Michael Dwyer. Slainter Michael, brave and true, then there rings a wild hurrah. As we sing, dear land, to you, aid us, Slainter Galgabrah. Fly the city, brothers, try, join us on the mountainside, where we've England's power defied, 20 men from Dublin town. I've been a wild rover for many a year, and I spent all me money on whiskey and beer. Ah, but now I'm returned with gold in great store, and I never will play the wild rover no more. And it's no, nay, never, no, nay, never, no more will I play the wild rover, no, never, no more. I went into an alehouse, I used to frequent, I told the landlady my money was spent. I asked her for credit, she answered me nay. Such a custom as yours I do not retain.
And it's no
sovereign's pride, and the landlady's eyes opened wide with delight. Says she, I have whiskey and wines of the best, and the words that I told you were only in jest.
And it's no, they never, no, they never, no more.
Sure.
Lancers are your Irish Fusiliers. The Aberdeen Militia are the King's own volunteers. Or any other regiment that's lying for the war, but give to me the tartan of the gallant 42. For well and then from far away, he wrote to me the tartan of the gallant 42.
Many's the ructions myself had a hand in. Bob Williamson lived a weaver by trade, and all of us thought him a stout orange blade. On the 12th of July, as it yearly did come, Bob played on the flute to the sound of the drum. You may talk of your harp, your piano, or lute, but there's none can compare with the old orange flute. Now Bob the deceiver, he took us all in, for he married a papish called Bridget McGinn, turned papish himself and forsook the old cause that gave us our freedom, religion and laws. Now the boys of the place made some comment upon it, and Bob had to fly to the province of Connaught. He fled with his wife and his vixens to boot, and along with the latter the old orange flute. At the chapel on Sundays to atone for past deeds, he said paters and aves and counted his beads, till after some time at the priest's own desire, Bob went with the old flute to play in the choir. Bob went with the old flute to play for the mass, but the instrument shivered and sighed, oh alas, and blow as he would, though it made a great noise, the flute would play only the Protestant boys. Bob jumped and he started and got in a flutter, and threw the old flute in the blessed holy water. He thought that this charm would bring some other sound. When he blew it again, it played Cruppy's Lie Down. And for all that he'd finger and whistle and blow to play papish music, he found it no go. Kick the Pope the boiling water, and freely would sound, but one papish squeak in it could not be found. At the council of priests that was held the next day, they decided to banish the old flute away. They couldn't knock heresy out of its head, so they bought Bob a new one to play in its stead. Now the old flute was doomed, and its fate was pathetic. 'Twas fastened and burned at the stake as heretic. As the flames roared around it, they heard a strange noise, but the old flute still playing the Protestant voice.
on Carrick Down, the heat is brown, the clouds are dark, or oddly, and many a stream comes rushing down to swell the
a song of peace and love, a whack for the diddle for the dido day, to the land that reigns all lands above, a whack for the diddle for the dido day. May peace and plenty be her share, who kept our homes from want and care. Oh, God bless England is our prayer, whack for the diddle for the dido day, whack for the diddle for the dido day. So we say, hip hooray, come and listen while we pray, whack for the diddle for the dido day. When we were savage, fierce and wild, whack for the diddle for the dido day, she came as a mother to her child, whack for the diddle for the dido day. Gently raised us from the slime, and kept our hands from a hellish crime, and sent us to heaven in her own good time. Whack for the diddle for the dido day, whack for the diddle for the dido day. So we say, hip hooray, come and listen while we pray, whack for the diddle for the dido day. Our fathers oft were naughty boys, whack for the diddle for the dido day, for pikes and guns are dangerous toys, whack for the diddle for the dido day.
From Bellonawi to Peter's Hill, they made poor England weep our fill.
But our Britannia loves us still. Whack for the diddle for the dido day. Whack for the diddle for the dido day. So we say, hip hooray, come and listen while we pray. Whack for the diddle for the dido day.
Oh, Irishmen, forget the past.
Whack for the diddle for the dido day.
And think of the day that is coming fast.
Whack for the diddle for the dido day.
When we shall all be civilized, neat and clean and well advised.
Oh, Mother England, be surprised. Whack for the diddle for the dido day. Whack for the diddle for the dido day. So we say, hip hooray, come and join the IRA. Whack for the diddle for the dido day. Whack for the diddle for the dido day. So we say, hip hooray, come and join the IRA. Whack for the diddle for the dido day.
Father was an Ulsterman, proud Protestant was he. My mother was a Catholic, from County Cork came she. They were married in two churches, lived happily enough, until the day that I was born and things got really rough.
Oh, it is the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. My father, he was orange, and my mother, she was green.
Baptized by Father Riley, then rushed away by car to be made a little orange man, me father's shining star. I was christened David Anthony, but still in spite of that, to me father I was Billy, while me mother called me Pat.
Oh, it is the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. Me father, he was orange, and me mother, she was green.
With mother every Sunday to mass I'd proudly stroll, and later on the Orange Lodge would try to save me soul. Both sides tried to claim me, but I was smart, because I'd play me flute or play me harp, depending where I was.
Oh, it's the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. My father, he was orange, and me mother, she was green.
Now when I'd sing those rebel songs, much to me mother's joy, me father would jump up and shout, look here now Bill me boy, we've had enough of that stuff, and he'd toss to me a coin, and he'd have me sing the orange flute and the heroes of the mine.
Oh, it is the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. Me father, he was orange, and me mother, she was green.
One day me father's kinfolk, they came to visit me, just as me mother's relatives were sitting down to tea. We tried to smooth things over, but they began to fight, and being strictly neutral, I bashed everyone in sight.
Oh, it's the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. Me father, he was orange, and me mother, she was green.
Me parents never could agree about me kind of school. Me learning was all done at home, no wonder I'm a fool. They both passed and God rest them, but they've left me caught between that awful colour problem of the orange and the green.
Oh, it is the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. Me father, he was orange, and me mother, she was green.
Usher Bailey had an engine that was always wanting mending, and according to her power, she could do 4 miles an hour.
Did you ever see, did you ever see, did you ever see such a funny thing before?
'Cause Usher bought her second hand, and he painted her so grand. When the driver went to oil her, man, she nearly burst her boiler.
Did you ever see, did you ever see, did you ever see such a funny thing before?
On the night run up from Gower, she did 15 miles an hour. As she whistled through the station, man, she wakened half the nation.
Did you ever see, did you
you ever see? Did you ever see such a funny thing before?
'Cause your Bailey's sister Anna, she do play the grand piano. She goes hammer, 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 and the neighbors say, well, damn her.
Did you ever see? Did you ever see? Did you ever see such a funny thing before?
'Cause your Bailey's cousin Rupert, he played scrum half for Newport, and they thought so much about him that they always played without him.
Did you ever see? Did you ever see? Did you ever see such a funny thing before?
'Cause your Bailey went to college for to get some extra knowledge, studied barmaids at the station and forgot matriculation.
Did you ever see? Did you ever see? Did you ever see such a funny thing before?
Oh, the sight it was heartrending, 'cause you drove his little engine, and he got stuck in the tunnel and shut up the bloomin' funnel.
Did you ever see? Did you ever see? Did you ever see such a funny thing before?
In the choir on Friday night, Kosher sings with all his might, and his version of Cumberanda makes the angels twist up yonder.
Did you ever see? Did you ever see? Did you ever see such a funny thing before?
Here's a hug to good old Wales, where they brew the best of ales. If you want a drink on Sunday, you'll just have to wait till Monday.
Did you ever see? Did you ever see? Did you ever see such a funny thing before?